the time series analysis, easy to use and minimal amount of data required needed. Assume that we are currently in period T. We calculate the forecast for the last period and we know the actual demand last period. So formula is given, Ft bar F T minus 1 plus alpha into A T minus 1 minus F T minus 1. Next. This is also an explanation, Sudhin. Next. So this is a weighted moving average. So the recent data gain the more weightage. Next. This is a double exponential Sudhin. Formula has been given. Next. Triple smoothing average. The machine will take all this automatically, so we need not worry to remember the formulas. Next. So now analytical framework for T. So linear regression model, mostly regression model is used by the RIMA. And in mathematical, or we are using this regression analysis. So linear regression, y equal to a plus bt plus et, that is a random variable. Non-linear regression, log y bar a plus b log t plus log e. Then exponential models, y bar a b raised to t plus e. Time series model, that is RIMA model. So where y is the dependent variable to be forecasted, t is the time period independent variable, and e is the error term at time period t. Next. Next. So these are the next. Food. Next. So these are the various formula for the analysis of the time period. Next. So this is the prime train fitted model, regression using regression model. So find a straight line that fits the database. So we have to find which straight line that fitting best to our model. So here y equal to intercept plus slope into x means b0 plus b1x. Slope that you all know, change in y divided by change in x. Next. This is real regression. Next. This is our real regression. Next. So assumption for the regression model. So randomness of the error. Error is always in the model, you know. Then zero mean of error. So we should try to find out the minimum error in the model. So where there is a, which model gives the minimum error, we should use that model. Then at almost cadenciousity, then normality, non-autocorrelation, and no perfect multicollinearity. These are the data problem, heteroscedity, that if it exists in the data, that we have to find it and remove it. But SPSS machine will take all this in care and give us the forecast. So, please. So, based on this, we have various RIMA models, as RIMA model, RIMA box ranking, SARIMA model signal, and arts and cars. Next. So, salient feature of the RIMA models. So, it is a mathematical models, regression model. They are widely used in economics, planning, hydrology, dendrochronology, and many other fields. Prediction based on this model are more reliable in comparison with the other models. So when there is a not much outlier problem in the data, RIMA model is the best. But when there is a high outlier, like this onion price this year, or pulses price in 2014-15, so when this type of outlier means irregular, highly irregular trend way in the data, at that time we have to smooth the data, because that If we not proper the smoothie data, it will not give us the proper result. Next. So this is the feature of the ARIMA. ARIMA means an autoregressive integrated moving average. It is a autoregressive integrated moving average. It has the three parts. First is the autoregressive. So what is autoregressive? ARP, where P order of autocorrelation. What is autocorrelation? Within the series data. Data within the series autocorrelated. And if data are autocorrelated, that it will give the spurious results. So ARIMA automatically takes into account and remove it. When we taking the MSc thesis problem, there is also problem in data, this type of autocorrelation, that we have to remove it. So it indicates weighted moving average over past observation. It is indicates weighted moving average over past observation. Then the integrated stationarity, ID, where D equal to order of integration. That is, differencing indicates the linear, irregular or polynomial trend. And MA, Q, where P, order of moving average, indicates weighted moving average over past errors. It is moving average of the errors. So ARP, AR is the observation moving autocorrelation, and MAQ is the errors moving average. Both are different. So we have to take the coefficient of variation, that is errors in the data over the years, and also autocorrelation. Next. So the
when we break for the
tea? Okay. Then within 15 minutes I will complete this, and next session we will take the practical. So the autoregressive model, ERP model or ARIMA P00 model. So AR1 model or ARIMA 00 model, that is formula is given YT equal to C plus phi into YT minus 1 plus UT, where YT observed value at time T, YT minus 1 previous observed value at time T minus 1. Yes, because we have monthly data, then first month, second month, like that. ET, error, random error, and C and phi, both are the constant that we available directly in the data. That ARIMA 1 and AR1 and AR2, both are the legs, AR2 model or ARIMA 200 model. Here only one constant increase. And ARP model for ARIMA P00 model, that is YT plus C plus phi into YT minus 1 plus Q2 YT minus 2 plus phi into P into YT minus P plus ET. Next. The moving average model MAQ for ARIMA 00. So ARIMA seasonal and non-seasonal. When there is a both, we have to do the seasonal analysis. So we have to use the both the seasonal and non-seasonal. So PDQ and PQ. So ARIMA 1 model for ARIMA 001 for the variance. YT equal to C plus Q1. I1 into ET minus 1, this is for the error variance, plus ET, where YT, ET the random error at time T, ET minus 1 the random error at time T minus 1. So it indicates the errors, what is the type of errors, or quantum of the errors, and that we also smooth it. MA2 at leg 2, model or ARIMA 002 model, and MAQ model or ARIMA 002 model. Next. So, beyond this, there are so many types of ARIMA model available. This is the mixed model, a mixed autoregressive moving average process containing P autoregressive tense and Q moving average tense. Means there are problems in both at the observation level and also at the variance level. So machine takes a lot of care. So ARIMA 1 or ARIMA 101 model. Next. So mixtures of model indicating all the problems. Next. So there are some also assumption for the operating of the ARIMA model. That is, data should be stationary. It should be indicate the normality data. No outliers. Means when there is a sudden increase or decrease in price, that we have to smooth it. No multi-collinearity in the data. No residual autocorrelation. In residual, there should be no autocorrelation. The series is homocharacteristic, i.e. errors have constant variance. So error variance should be constant, not different thing. Next. So this is the when we go for the series analysis, then we have to identify the whole series. First step in the model building step is the identification. First step is the identification. We have to identify since which type of problem exists in the data, which type of problem exists in the data. So choosing tentative P, D and Q, whether it is a AR series or MS series or mixed frequency. Parameter estimations. Diagnostic check are the individual white noise. So after the modeling, the residual should left should be only the white noise, not the other residues. So if all this happens and we find it satisfactory, then we go for the use of that model. If we find that there is some problems, inherent problems in the data, that it contains the air autocorrelation or the heteroscedasticity, then we have to go for the control model. So if no, then we have to go for the another type of model. But if we find it is the best, then we go for the forecast. Okay. So these are the some pattern exhibited by the ARIMA model. So in the identification step, using graphs, statistic, autocorrelation function. What is autocorrelation function? Will come next in slide. And partial autocorrelation functions. Both autocorrelation function and partial autocorrelation function are different. Its definition is given in next slides. Transformation, etc., to achieve stationary and tentatively identity patterns and model components. So we have to identify the data and should make it stationary. So this is the illustration of the autocorrelation and SAF function, where value d equal to 0 means there is no need of differencing. If differencing is required, then difference 1 is to be taken. Most of the series at first difference will become the stationary. Rare cases we have to go for the second differencing. Next. Estimation. Determine coefficient and estimate through software application of least squares and maximum likelihood methods. Next, diagnostic stage. Significant coefficient, lower value of AIC and BIC. Akai correlation, that is coefficient. And SAF and PSAF of white noise residual to verify whether the model is valid or not. And forecasting using graphs, simple statistic and confidence interval to determine the validity of the forecast. Next. So this is the identification process of the data. So what is stationary data? Stationary means that there is no growth or decline in the data. Means data should be smooth. that is near to horizontal to the x-axis. If that series is exhibited in graph, that is we can call it a testing data. So it has no growth and no decline. So it is the testing data. So if there is a data non-testinary, then we have to make it testinary. So taking the first depressing, that is yt equal to yt minus, yt minus 1 means
from the second observation
we have to minus the first observation, and what is difference, we have to prepare the based on that difference we have to prepare the next series, and next series generally will be the stationary series. If next series is not stationary, then we have to go for the second difference. But machine takes automatic everything. Second differencing, and by removing the tail in the data. Test for stationarity. So if data are not stationary, we know it by the Dickey Pro test. That is it, people know it very well. Then the integrated process, D or one part of Parima, that zero, D zero, means it is a differencing process. Next. So this is the illustration of the Dow Jones index, that is non-testing data. So it is suddenly decrease, then suddenly decrease. When this type of series are available for the analysis, then by taking the difference, we have to stabilize. So here below series is a difference series, and it is, you look like the stable series. Next. So seasonality is common, that you all know. Next. So examining correlation, that is what is correlation coefficient. So the autocorrelation function, that is RK. So it is equal to summation of YT minus Y into YT minus K minus Y from T equal to K plus 1 to N divided by the summation yt minus y whole square t from 1 to n. So the ACF is sequence of correlation between yt and yt minus 1, yt and yt minus 2. So it is correlation between observation first to second, from observation first to second and third, observation first to second, third, fourth, like it. So and so on, without holding the effect of earlier legs on yt constant. So here, in this data, correlation, autocorrelation is with second observation, third observation has correlation with the first observation. What? Observation has the correlation with the first observation. So it is the, without holding the effect constant. So this is the autocorrelation function. Without holding the effect of earlier legs on yt. In practice, accurate estimate of ACFK requires minimum of about n equal to 50 observation, where k known as the leg should not be larger than approximately n by 4 observation. The PACF control for the effect of previous leg, but the ACF does not control for such effect. So PACF is a partial autocorrelation. So first observation in ACF, first observation correlated with the second, third observation also correlated with the first, second, like that. So there is no control. But in PACF, there is a partiality. First observation is correlated with second, but second, third observation is not correlated with the first. So it is called the partial. So sampling distribution of the autocorrelation with white noise series lies with the plus minus 1.96 into n, under root n. Next. So this is the autocorrelation coefficient at the left 2, 4, 8 and 10. And this is the autocorrelation coefficient. So this coefficient is within the range. See. Next. The partial autocorrelation. So the PACF is the sequence of correlation between YT and YT minus 1, YT and YT minus 2, YT and YT minus 3, and so on, given the effect of allele lengths on the YT held constant. So here it is constant. In ACF it is not constant. So this is the difference between ACF and PACF. So autocorrelations in ACF not held constant, in PACF it is held constant. So this is the formula given and it's standard error. Next. So these are the some pictures of the partial autocorrelation coefficient and theoretical ACF and PACF at ER1 and identification of the model. Next. These are also some theoretical ACF and PACF for ER2 model at LEG2. Next. So expected pattern in the ACF and PACF for simple AR and MA model. So what type of trend is available? We can judge on the ER1, that is exponential decay on positive side of phi that is greater than 0 and alternating in sign starting on negative side if phi less than 0. So these are all pattern inbuilt in the SPSS, so we need not to bother it. Yes. This is the phase 2, estimating. So estimation requires estimation of the parameter in potential. Select best model using suitable criteria, diagnosis, check ACF, PACF of residual. Do not portmanteau test, do portmanteau test of residuals. Are the residuals white noise or not? So if only white noise residual set, we are not in our control. Means there is no mistake in data, everything. Only the white noise should be left and other, whatever the effect is there, it should be removed. So criteria for the selection of the model. A possible criteria for choosing the best ERIMA model might appear to be to choose the model which gives the smallest sum of square errors, smallest sum of square errors, or the largest value of the likelihood. So what is maximum likelihood criteria? Computer program for fitting ERIMA model will automatically find appropriate initial estimate of the parameters and then successively refine them until the optimum values of the parameter are found using maximum likelihood criteria. Diagnostic check. For a good forecasting model, the residual left over after fitting the model should be simply white noise. Therefore, if the ACF and PACF of the residual are obtained, we would hope to find no significant autocorrelation and no significant partial autocorrelation left. Next. So these are the summary of the estimation of the coefficient given. So it should be significant. Then we go for the test. Next. So the portmanteau test. So common portmanteau test is box ranking test, which is based on the box pairs Q statistics, Q equal to N. Summation of R square K, the K rise from 1 to H. H is the maximum leg being considered, N variable number of observation in the series, Q has I square distribution with H minus M degree of freedom, M in the number of operators in the model. So phase 3 forecasting use model. Conclusion, prediction based on these models are more reliable comparison with the other models. Limitation of the ERIMA. For reliable prediction, at least 70 observations are required. We should have at least 7 years data if function data is there. So this is the R-class model. When there is large variation in data, we go for the R class or N RT special. This is this description. Next. So now when we say that model is a good,
when we say that the
which model we use is a good, so confidence coefficient of determination R square. So we all know that when R square is maximum, that what model should be used. Root mean square error, RMSE,
should be less.
Mean absolute error, MAE, less. Mean absolute percentage error, that is MAPI,
in ARIMA,
MAPI is the best judgment. So MAPI should be around in between 3 to 7. Up to 7 we can go for the testing. So if MAPI is more than that, then model is not used. Then AKAI information criteria, AIC, and Seward's information criteria, SIC. So low value of RMSE, MAE, AIC, SIC are preferred for a good model. Next. So this is the evolution of forecasting model. If we have forecasted the model, and whether it is a proper or not, so using the bias formula, BIS, the arithmetic mean of the error. BIS means actual value minus forecast divided by n equal to error, summation of error divided by n. So n is the number of forecast errors in Excel. This is worked out like that, average error range. Mean absolute error, MAD. MAD equal to summation actual minus forecast divided by n equal to summation error divided by n. So this will we can work out in the Excel also. Next. Then this is the formula for measuring the MSE, mean square error. MSE equal to actual minus forecast whole square divided by n equal to summation error square divided by n, and mean percentage error. This MAPI is mostly used. Actual minus forecast divided by actual multiplied by 100 divided by observations. So R square for curve fitting models such as regression, in general, the lower the error means bias, MAD and MSE, or the higher the R square, better the forecasting model. Yes. So this is the feature of the good forecast model, that it is timeliness, accuracy, reliability, meaningful. The method should be easy to use and understand. So ARIMA model is comparatively, compared with the arch and graph, it is very easy to understand, because when complex model is used, we cannot interpret it properly. Okay.
We have forecast price series, and with the use of that price series, we will do the forecast using the array.